Greenwood.
They don't leave until Friday, do they?
I don't know. I thought they left Monday. Well, still, he said, don't look it up. So what did everybody, me and about six other people I've seen doing around me and looking it up. I told him before he left, so it's really be careful. It was really nasty by down as I looked it up.
Like, I think he went last year, though.
Yeah, but still.
Yeah, I know.
Any part, it's like one of the worst, well, not the worst, but one of the worst places in Chicago. Although, you don't hear much on the news now about all the murders and other things that have been happening, like they had in the last couple of years, where they had now 50 or 100 people killed in like a weekend.
I think I have a cousin that still lives
there. I suppose depending what part of town you live in, it's not made it on an issue. Big town.
Yeah, Inglewood is like a, I assume it's a suburb.
Yeah, I think so. I looked it up. Part of the overall metro one.
His dad has a friend that lives there. Or, like, was living there. I'm assuming he still is.
Thank you. That's what I tried to tell him when you were going, oh, the old apartment. Especially if you want to pull through there with your trailer and stuff like that. Holding it together. Danielle's going to stay until she finishes her. She's getting a second degree.
Yeah.
Social,
education.
Social. Is it social work and addiction counseling? I'm not sure. But she's getting another degree.
Yeah. Education. Well, she decided she wanted to teach because she already has her social work one, I think, or her addiction counseling.
So,
I could never understand why she wanted to do that, but now she said she doesn't want it to.
Oh, I forgot to ring the bell. I left.
Yeah, well, it's, again, we haven't been there in a
while. That held the door for me.
Right. You're still doing that.
But we went in there not knowing the restaurant. Yeah. Which was so tough.
Yep.
So, Huey and his crew.
I didn't recognize that guy when I first saw him.
Yeah,
he's the one who had that little kid that had the breathing problems.
Right.
We don't see him in church anymore. So maybe they go to the later service. Oh, they got a bunch of kids.
Up there until it's time to move over. I'll try to jam.
Well, it looks like it's open until you get to the cross and the bridge there. So they zip on up there.
Until everybody else slam on the brakes to make the wall fall.
Yeah.
What's
the guy just did.
So it's there getting more and more of the concrete on that side. They've been doing some more pours, so. Good. This is going to be a mess.
It's a very expensive project, too.
You think? I would think that a dike 30-foot thick would be stronger than that wall. I don't know.
As long as they don't have to say in a couple of years.
It didn't do it. It did it wrong. Yeah. It reinforced the wall with the dike. Well, there we are. Yes, that's right. That's what I see coming if there's another flood, they'll pile clay.
And they're even saying they're not going to be done with it for another 10 years.
Well, like the ones at Grand Forks, it took a long time to build it. You know, people were sneaking back down there buying stuff.
The sheriff going there.
Yeah, well, maybe that's the time.
Officials say squirrels damaged cable that was supposed to end up running in April. The squirrels chew through the internet wires. Frankfort, Kentucky. Why am I not news reported that?
Where is it? For what area?
I don't know. It's a place in Kentucky.
Kentucky.
Frankfort, Kentucky.
Copper or was it fiber?
I don't know. Probably fiber. They were trying to look for nuts. It would have been more exciting if it would have been like a highly energized power wire.
Zapperoo. I'd say we don't.
I see
there.
People sitting there, but I don't know why.
They're there, but the trailer's
there's
out
no trailer.
Yeah, oh, we're waiting for the big one. I'm going to come by and annoy them just for fun. Yeah,
don't stay too long.
Work. Just thought I'd say hi.
Okay, don't stay too long because some of us
I don't have any time,
forgot so. To go to the bathroom at Arby's, so we're kind of on the edge.
It's like Jerry and Joe and
Bob.
And Bob.
Yeah, that's
what it looks like.
Oh, yeah, okay, they got the Dodger.
Yep.
Rich tried to get a hold of Joe. I should tell him not. The radio a little bit ago.
Joe's been trying to get you on the radio.
Rich.
Rich has been trying to get you on the radio. W0HVA, W0HVA, AB0 Kilo Zulu.
Welcome to the K.
Now he won't talk to me, probably.
W repeater.
Probably not. Let's see if I can get him on Facebook.
AB0KZ, W0HVA, go ahead, John.
I'm at the site. Joe's over here with the tower trailer and Bob and Jerry.
Had a little late start in Bismarck. I'm right by the college now.
At Minot State or Bismarck State? Which college, sir?
What was that? I missed part.
Which college are you near?
Just at 11th Avenue and Broadway, about 2 minutes away.
Very good. I've got to run, but I'll relay the message. Thank you. 2 minutes. He's at Minot State. Yo. Try it again.
They'll figure it out when he gets here.
Joe, 2 minutes. Hello. Yeah, because everything's going to be on this side. There's only going to be one trailer and tower. So, we will turn around.
I was going to say, we probably want to get out of here. Watch out for the sticks.
I see them.
Want to get out of there before they get the building.
Goodness, if we hadn't had too many, we'd be stuck here.
That's why we got Jerry's truck.
I posted the thing on the service for like it says, starting to set up. North Main at the airport.
Mr. Texted Joe because Joe took out his phone and looked at it.
Yeah. Oh, I didn't text him.
No, but when Rich couldn't get a hold of him, he probably texted him.
Maybe not. I don't know. Or Elaine texted him, maybe.
But he said he got a late start.
Pretty good time to do it. Let's get there and do it.
But I mean, he was on the phone quite a while ago.
Yeah. With the radio.
Probably both.
Well, he went down to Icelandic State Park. Or Crossrand State Park, I should say. He went down to Cross Ranch because they had some jazz or bluegrass thing.
Bluegrass thing. He does bluegrass.
Yeah, whatever it is. Thingy. There's a pretty good chunk of open land. We gotta do something with it. Yeah, one usually see the turkeys up.
Something to hear, too.
Mm-hmm. You don't want to see honey badger. I think they only needed like South Africa or something. Or Africa, sorry, not sure.
Hey,
put a swimming
gathering
pool. Put a swimming pool in there.
No, just a
big hole and just put water in it. Why not? It's the perfect place to have it. Swimming pool in the area there. For a skating rink. Very nice. Everybody, they took everything down to basic foundations.
Studs,
and then rebuilt.
That's what you have to do.
Well,
make sure you don't have the mold.
Yeah.
Or anything else. Bottom line was, yeah, the time.
But a lot of people that did that now have basically brand new houses.
Yeah, up to new code.
Yeah, all up new code.
Yeah.
Well, that's the thing is, at least for a few more years, is if you want to buy a to determine if it was in the flood, you just have to look and see if it has brand new windows.
Yeah.
Because if it has brand new windows, they had to replace everything.
Yeah.
Which is probably good, because a lot of those houses that were...
I was going to say...
7IVW0HBA mobile.
Doesn't hurt to look.
0HVA, clear.
Lynn's gonna be here. I wonder if Lynn's gonna be here. I feel bad. Probably not.
I don't know. I
thought you were gonna go up and check.
I'm not in charge of anything.
Okay. Somebody stopped us before.
Well, then the first thing I got out of Dave was, I hope John's got this, this, and that. That's, that's not quite the way I remembered this.
You volunteered. You were there, volunteered.
No one else would.
Yeah, that's how everything goes in our club, it seems like.
Didn't you say you volunteered someone because they weren't there?
That's how Joe got
volunteered. Mm-hmm. No, you don't show up for a meeting, they just volunteer you for stuff. Now, if you do show up for a meeting, they'll still volunteer you for stuff. Interesting way it works, isn't it? They can vote you in as officer, too. Stop being trustee.
Yeah.
Our homes.
Trustee. Yeah. Okay, two brevets, both of them large, extra shot, one caffeinated, one decaf, a Titan frozen mocha, sugar free extra shot. No whipped cream. Huh? Yeah, sort of, yeah.
I'm signed in on the app.
Okay. Thank you.
Oh, we have one free drinky.
It's a Ford Raptor. Well,
yeah.
There's a lot.
Yeah. If you send it and have it the Hennessy performance pet mod puts on it, and it comes
probably
the,
just fine.
Then it comes with the Hennessy Velociraptor.
Probably just fine.
700 horsepower, man. So the
one
standard 450.
There, but then he's got a paper one up there.
Probably forgot to take it down.
Get the standard 450 engine, 3.6 liter, and then he sent it to Hennessy, and they put the 5.7 liter Hemi in there. And they up it to 750 horsepower. Yeah. If you have the extra, you know. $35,000 to spend, sure.
Assuming it's a cell phone dual bin.
But of course, they put the heavy duty off road package onto that too, so. Skid
the
plates.
Small one in the back?
They put the skid, the Hennessy Performance mod, they
on top of
put
that
the bigger engine in it with more horsepower, and they up the suspension, put bigger tires on it, give it a 2-inch lift for the bigger suspension. Oh, it's nice. Yeah, extra $35,000 off.
It's not that
but it's really nice. Good luck getting it stuck. And if you do get it stuck, you're probably going to need a tank retriever to get it out.
Brendan.
Yeah.
wish they'd let them sell Toyota Hiluxes in the United States. Those are badass trucks. So we got 7,300, so there you go. Different elevations, get different stuff. We only got 3,400s at the house on the cell tower.
Yeah,
and so do I. No.
I don't know.
So you can actually look at their menu for a local store. You can order off their stuff and have your order ready to go when you come in. Mm-hmm. Kind of like a lot of other places are doing now. You can do the Pizza Ranch and other things, you know, or you could have delivery. Pick up a delivery. I don't know if Hardee's has that. I doubt Hardee's has that. Some, a lot of them do, though. A lot of them have the option. First time I ever used it where a pickup thing was, I ordered that Karen backpack like 9:30 in the morning, and it was ready to go by 9:45, and it said on the app, allow an hour. I'm like, oh, I don't know, 15 minutes, man. None of this having to go all the way back to the wherever, find the stinking thing, or be lost for six hours or something.
Then?
Yeah, it was in store pickup because I didn't want to wait another week. I didn't want to wait a week to have it be picked up or by shipping.
Mm-hmm.
So it cost the same as it would have been to ship it, but sometimes the online deals are better than the indoor deals. Which they usually do like price guarantee things if you see it cheaper on their website versus whatever's labeled in the store. I did that with my gaming headset. I got like $10 off because it was $10 cheaper online for that store than it was actually in store. I just showed that to them and they're like, okay, price match guarantee. Yeah.
Called up last night after. She's had this many bookings trying to get a price guarantee, and she wants it to be a price guarantee to what it was back up there. And I said, well, and I see that there's a mismatch with the air. And I see that. Well, I want them to just do that. And I said, well, the way I understand it, so it was making it sound like I'm working in the market unless I have to.
Did Morgan tell you already your guys' name for the person behind you? I don't know if you know them,
but I don't know that I do, but oh my gosh, thank you. Thank you.
And I got your punches on
the This is John's?
Yep.
Okay.
Maybe they saw the veteran plate or something.
That's possible.
Do you have your call sign on that one?
No, I have the 632nd SPs.
Oh, maybe they were in that. Or yep. Knew somebody in there. Could be a veteran thing because they've been having a lot of veteran stuff lately. June.
I was going to hold the door for the guy that had one false leg. Yeah, and I opened it, and the lady was walking in, and she went through, and then the guy held the door, and he said, no, you can come on through, ma'am.
Yeah, stick your hand outside and wait until the end. Or whoever. Or just somebody doing something nice for somebody.
Yeah,
just
right.
Not yeah. see too much of that anymore, really. Yeah. Yeah, you don't see that too much with...
All right, there you go.
Okay, so, well, tell them thank you very much.
I got you.
Okay.
Thanks.
Have a good day.
Yes.
Bye-bye.
Then again, it might be somebody who actually knows us.
I don't recognize a big...
I don't recognize it either.
Looks like a nice truck.
Yeah, it does.
Looks like the one that we were sitting behind.
Might have been.
That big foreign plant truck. I can't tell what the plate was. Nice though.
It's nice.
Windows and new doors
a couple of years before the flood.
Yeah, you can usually tell though. Most of these new windows have the white oak trim on them. Not all, but some.
Because even before the flood, we saw people putting windows in.
Yeah, but still. Majority of the time though, you saw. Because now you look at almost all these houses now and you look and they got the white trims on the window thingies. You know, especially the ones that weren't closer to the river. I mean, even the basement windows are that way.
I haven't tendency to look for the water line.
Usually the basement, yeah, but usually the water basement windows don't usually are not the ones that are sealed. So if you look at the basement windows,
I mean, the water line on the building.
Well,
AKW repeater.
I don't know if it's more rain today. I don't know. I haven't looked through
it. It says on it.
Yeah, I know, but not always does it mean. Unless you look at the radar. Like, this stuff was moving so slow last night, I wasn't sure it was even going to get here. You know what's frightening? There's only a little bit of rain out by south of Tioga. There's, like, otherwise there's nothing else on radar to the west of us.
That's probably why we slept.
Otherwise, there's still well east of us, like, north of Harvey, up to the Peace Gardens. There's just a little bit of rain around just south of Tioga, around just a little bit west of Stanley. And I'm talking just like a couple little thunder showers. That's it. They say real hot. They're talking it could be hotter the next 10 days or something, like getting starting to get back to the more normal or above normal.
Well, tomorrow's the
but I don't really see that for field day. I don't see, they're saying like 73 for high, 52 for low. So I'm like, well, that's not too bad. The only good thing with lack of moisture is that there hasn't been a ton of mosquitoes. So, yeah, I've had a couple nip on me that I didn't know nipped on me, and they did spray. So, at the beginning of the month, so that probably kept them down too, but
yeah.
But they said they released a thing for the drought thingy yesterday.
Yeah,
and it was
even,
and we were almost 4.5 inches from what we should be for normal.
It says 15.
So, probably up to 3.5. I don't understand what this does, really.
Well, they're rebuilding this bridge.
Yeah.
One of the things.
I don't quite understand why.
This stuff.
Yeah, I don't quite understand the massive turn.
Well, they're building
this all implies.
Whatever they're doing.
Yeah. When she goes early, she usually asks for, like, it with, like, extra mayo. Which I'm finding really hard. I'm like, she likes mayo more than I like to ketchup. She was just crazy. I don't mind it, but I don't like it, like, gross smokes.
Was today and she went
stovetop stuff, you know.
I'm assuming you're talking about your frozen milk.
Mm-hmm. You can reduce the coffee.